One of the best ways not to forget history is, of course, to hear the stories and share in the memories of those who lived it. When it comes to Canada's veterans, the soldiers who fought in the wars of the 20th century, that means finding some kind of a way to chronicle their experiences before they are no longer with us. With that in mind, Larry Cappetto is here with us today. He's a documentary filmmaker. He's already finished one project chronicling the stories of Canadian veterans and lots of other vets around the world. Now he's here in Montreal this week working on another one, interviewing vets for his next documentary. Larry, thanks for coming, first of all. And why is this so important to you as a project?
Well, I titled my series, Todd, Lest They Be Forgotten. If we don't remember, we're going to forget. And I think society as a whole, we tend to forget our veterans who have served in our countries. I'm an American filmmaker here in Montreal, working on my second film featuring war veterans in this area and documenting the history of what they went to. I told you earlier, it's like touching history as I've opened up and talked to these veterans and they opened up to me and shared stories with me that they've never told me before. It's given me a great opportunity to document the history that they were a part of and then to share that with future generations.
Why? I know you've done a number of them, not only on Canada's vets, you did one, you're doing another one, but you've done ones on U.S. vets, different wars. Why has this become such a labor of love for you?
You know, people tell me I'm doing the work of God. It's like a ministry. It's a labor of love. Exactly is what it is. I feel compelled to tell the stories of these veterans. They're my eyes and my ears to something that happened in the case of the World War II veterans 60 years ago. You know, it's like going back in time and reliving an experience with them as they land on these beaches under enemy fires. They come home and transition back into civilian life and all the personal things that happened to them. And it's become a mission of mine. My father served in the Korean War and my uncle was in World War II, so there's some military history there. But my goal is to honor and recognize our veterans and to thank them for what they've done. We just went through Remembrance Day. We should never forget what these veterans have done.
When you're talking to them and doing these interviews with them, what do they think about this idea, about preserving their stories and their memories?
I think a lot of the older veterans can sense the urgency of the times, and they're opening up and talking to me for the first time. I'd say 75% of the veterans that I speak with have never told their stories before, and that's profound to me. It's like, who am I? Why are they talking to me? Well, number one, they know that I care, and I want to listen to their story, and I provide a very non-threatening environment so they can open up. Therefore, that's the power behind what I do. It's very unrehearsed, and they're very all supportive of sharing this with our younger generations, teaching them that freedom is never free.
You know, it's fascinating. You talked about Remembrance Day, and back in November, I had the opportunity to interview a vet who was in the chair where you are right now, and it's really true. I found it fascinating, the stories that he was able to recount to us about what he went through, being a witness to history, literally there on the battlefields of Europe, in his case it was Italy, and just watching it with your own eyes. And we don't understand that, I don't think, people nowadays who never fought in wars.
Mm-hmm. You don't. You know, you go to a movie and you see a war movie, for instance, and you're seeing the whole picture. When you're getting off a landing craft, fighting in a battle, you see what's before you. And the one thing that's missing from a movie is the smell of war, the smell of combat. You know, I've learned two things through all the interviews I've done, that war is hell and freedom's not free. And we have all these memories bottled up inside of a lot of these veterans, and I find when they talk about it, it releases something. It's therapeutic. There's a healing process, I think, with a lot of them that have suffered the emotional scars of war.
Now, you have a website, veteranshistory.org, which people can go to get more information about the DVDs that you already have done, the documentaries that you've done. What else is on there people can look at?
They can see pictures of all the veterans I've interviewed before and current. They can see trailers of all the films. I've just finished my 10th film, a lot of the American films and the Canadian films I'm working on are there, and they can just find more information about the project, upcoming projects too, and my travel schedule, where I will be and how to contact me if they want to be interviewed. I dare to say there's people listening to this that have veterans in their families that would like to talk to me. I would encourage them to talk to me. And can I say something about my interviews here this week? I've been interviewing here in Montreal. I work with Kane and Federley Funeral Home here. They're my sponsor here, so they've allowed me this opportunity to come here, and because of that, I've interviewed about 3 dozen veterans already.
Wow. I want to thank you for coming in today and talking to us.
Well, I thank you for your time.
Appreciate it.